Hello friends, welcome to KSP Academy. The last class we have discussed the two portrait of parameters. In that we have completed Z parameter calculation, Y parameter calculation, followed by H parameter calculation, so we completed. Now we are switched on to the fourth parameter, that is called as G parameter. G parameter also called as inverse of H parameters. Inverse H parameters, so we call this. So G parameters, what is going to have, the things are going to happen in this. In this, I1 V2, this is what is going to happen is I1 V2 are dependent parameters. Next here it is V1 I2 are independent parameters. I1 V2 are dependent parameters, V1 I2 are independent parameters. In this we need to calculate G11 G12 G21 G22, is 4 parameter we have to be calculated. So for the sake of understanding, first to write the equation formats, what is going to happen here? I1 is equal to G11 V1, G12 I2. Next, V2 is equal to G21 V1, G22 V2. This is the equation we got it is. So to analyzing of these components, we need to go for two methods. In the case of method 1, out of these two independent sources, one independent source will shut down. One independent source will shut down. So in the case of case 1, I am writing it as case 1, is here it is, I2 should go to be 0. Case 1, what I am writing? I2 should go to 0. Nothing but output port. Output port is either one is open circuited. Output port is open circuited. Nothing but what is going to happen is here it is I2 is equal to 0. I2 is equal to 0. The moment I2 should be 0, this component should be 0. So what is going to get by here it is values? G11 is equal to I1 by V1. So second case, what is going to get by here? G21 is equal to V2 by V1 is what it is. Understood? So calculate these parameters. Let us take a sample network, T network, I am assuming here. Let us take a sample network, here it is, a T network, R1, R2, R3. So what is going to do R1, R2, R3? Now let us applying your apply voltage V1, the current I1 will flow, current I2 should come like this, V2 over here it is. Next, this is what the case one here. I2 should be 0. I2 should be 0 means here this drop should be neglected. This drop should be 0. So according to the KVL we can apply here. V1 is equal to I1 R1. Next I1 plus I2 into R3. Then I2 should be 0. So we can write directly here it is I1 into R1 plus R3. But I1 by V1 we want. So let us write from this. G11 is equal to I1 by V1 is equal to 1 by R1 plus R3 we got it is. So G1 calculates number. Have you got understanding? Next. So second case. Next. The output voltage is the output current is there, but output voltage is there. So output voltage equal to the voltage, output voltage the output voltage equal to here, the voltage drop across R3. V2 is equal to the voltage drop across R3 because this property should be 0. So I can write directly here, V2 is equal to what current will flow? I1 and I2 current will flow, but default I2 is 0. So I1 into R3. But we want V2 and V1 relation, but we want I1, we don't want I1. From this, I am writing it as this equal what can write V1 you can write from this. So from this, here we can write on I1 is equal what can I write from this? I1 is substitute over here. So V2 is equal to I1 is equal to V1 into R3 by R1 plus R3. So what do you want? V2 by V1 you want. So G21 is equal to V2 by V1 is equal to R3 by R1 plus R3. So case 1, G21 we got it is. Now switch on to the case 2 here. Case 2, what do we do? This part should be going to shut down. Nothing but input port is short circuited. Input port is short circuited means V1 is equal to 0. Input voltage, that is V1 is equal to 0. With moment the V1 should be 0, what are the components will come? This part should be 0, these two components will come. Second, G12 is equal to I1 by I2. Second case, G22 is equal to V2 by I2 we got this. So to calculate these components, let us take same your T networks. So let us draw a small T network. Same analysis, R1, R2, R3. This are applying a V1 voltage here, V2 voltage here. I1 should go like this, I2 should go like this. What is going to happen is that V1 should be 0. The moment V1 should be 0, this should be short circuited. The moment this should be short circuited, what I mean in this two, I should take the parallel connection. So let us write on the circuit here. A small network. V2 are applying voltage. Here it is R2, R1, R3. Current will come over here. I2 current is coming over here. These two are parallel. So apply a KVL here. V2 is equal to R2 plus R2 parallel R1 parallel R3 followed by I2 R2, so I should take on I2 R2 plus these two are parallel R1 plus R3. I2 is good. But what do you want here? V2 by I2 you want. So let us write directly there. G22 is equal to V2 by I2 is equal to R2 plus R1 R3 by R1 plus R3. This we can write down. Simple thing. So we got G2 also we got it is. We want G12. So later I should take here. Same the current difference concept I should take. Later an assumption a current flowing through this R1 branch I am taking. It is an IX current. So current should like this. IX current is equal to minus I1. So IX is equal to minus I1 is equal to the current flowing to this branch is equal to according to current division rule the source current is coming I2 is splitting into the current flowing to what is current flowing through. So I2 current is coming on the current will flow through R2 resistor, the current will flow through R1 resistor also. But I want the current flowing through this R1 resistor is equal to total current is coming over here I2. Total current is coming over here, I2 current into opposite resistor means what? R3 by summation of two resistors. R1 plus R3. So what do you want here? I1 by I2 you want. So G12 is equal to I1 by I2 is equal to this minus 10 show like this. Minus R3 by R1 plus R3. This is what G12. I hope you understand it. For current division rule, I1 by I2 is equal to minus R3 by R1 plus R2. So one confirmation you will understand it is G12 is equal to plus R3 by R1 plus R3. G12 is equal to here minus R3 by R1 plus. So what is the confirmation here? G12 is equal to minus G2. This is following a reciprocity condition as well as a symmetrical network. I hope you are very clear understanding why you have to calculate G parameters. The laboratory also, if you know V1 videos, we can play whatever you want it is. In the laboratory, if they mention it is a pi network, convert it to T network and do it out. You can get easily like a star network compared to that pi networks. I hope I very clearly. Thanks for watching. Continue. Keep continuous.